Welcome back, dear. So in this video, we're going to discuss about the different operations that can be performed in data structure along with abstract data type. What is abstract data type? Okay, so data structure is a way of storing, organizing, and making some operations in data. Okay, and we have seen the different classifications of data structures too. So the different operations that can be performed in data structure, these are all the common four main operations. Like whenever you take a data structure, we should know how to traverse the data or data structure. So traversal in the sense, like we have to visit each and every content in a data, okay, only once. So that is called traversal. For example, when I just take some 10 cities, I have to visit all the 10 cities only once. Okay, so that is called traversal. So based on the algorithm, or based on the structure, data structure, this way in which the data are viewed, right, that varies. For example, when it is a linear data structure, we can start from the starting. Since it is in a sequence, we can visit one by one. But what happened in a tree data structure or a graph data structure, we cannot use that kind of thing, right? So based on the type of data structure, this operation actually varies. Okay, so traversal is visiting each and every node only once. And searching is, we have to search whether particular data present in the data structure or not. Okay, so we have to start from the starting node, check whether that particular node or particular place we are searching is available in the data structure or not. And insertion is when you want to insert a new record into the existing data structure, how you're going to perform. Okay. And deletion, when you want to delete a record with a particular data set, how you are going to perform. Okay, so these are all the four major data structure operations which will be seen for each and every data structure separately and how the actual algorithmic way in which it is executed. Okay, so all those things are going to be discussed. Along with these operations, we have two special operations, that is sorting and merging. Okay, sorting is like you have a data structure or a database, we want to sort it in an ascending or descending order. So how are you going to perform? And there are different algorithms actually works for it. And you're going to choose the best algorithm for sorting technique. And when you have two records, how you're going to merge it. Okay, so I'll discuss that in the previous video itself. When the fields actually matches, we can append it. And when we have taken two different sorted arrays, we have to sort them. The resultant merged array should also be of sorted way. Okay, and one more thing, like when you are going to club the places, the location also matters. Okay, so we have to make these operations carefully for each and every. Like we have to learn how it is implemented. Okay, how the logical working should be there for each and every data structure. Okay. So traversal is accessing each and every record only once, and searching is finding for a record. Okay, and we have to return either the key value or the position. Insertion is adding a new data, new record to the structure. Deletion is removing the existing record out of that. And sorting is arranging the record in any logical order. Merging is combined two files together. Okay, and next one is abstract data type. So abstract data type is something like we are going to club. Okay, so we are going to encapsulate a data structure along with its operation. For example, when I take stack, stack has its own way of representing data, own way of inserting data, own way of deleting data. Okay, so user can directly call it as stack. The inbuilt representations are hidden. Okay, so any data structure, along with the operations, it is actually encapsulated together and it is hidden from the user. Hidden in the sense, like when a data structure is taken, these are all the operations that can be performed by the data structure, not other than that. Okay, so that will be taken, encapsulated together, and that is represented as a data type, abstract data type. Okay, so we just call the structure alone. We call it as stack, insertion and stack. Okay, so how it is actually performing is encapsulated, it is hidden from the user. Okay, so this is called an abstract data type. When I take an array, array has certain functions. Okay, so we have to perform the functions as given per the user. Okay, when I want to search for and like when I want to extract the 10th element from an array, I know exactly how to do. Okay, so we are not going to say how it is actually implemented. We are not going to look into that details. Okay, we just call A of 9. Okay, since indexing starts from 0, 9th position will have a 9th A of 0, A of 9 will have the 10th element. Okay, so directly call the value, you'll get it. Okay, the actual way of implementation is hidden from the user. Okay, so this is called abstract data type. When you are in your exam point of view, when you are asked to explain about array data structure, array abstract data type, or linked list abstract data type, stack ADT or QADT and all, you have to describe in detail about the function of Q, the way in which the data are organized, what all the operations that can be performed, along with its algorithmic representation. Okay, so abstract data type, it actually represents any data structure along with its operation. Okay.
Thank you.